In this lecture, I would like to discuss about crystal field stabilization energy. So this topic is related to the crystal field splitting in complexes. In previous lecture, we has been discussed about the crystal field splitting in octahedral complexes. So we know how the orbitals are splitted, how the d orbitals are splitted into the two groups, where one group is having lower energy level, that is T2g, and other group is having higher energy level, that is Eg. So the 5d orbitals of the central metal ion cannot remain degenerate. In presence of the surrounding ligand field, the 5d orbitals are splitted into the two groups, that is T2g, triply degenerate orbitals, and Eg, doubly degenerate orbitals. So now 5d orbitals are divided in the two energy levels. You can see here the 5d orbitals are splitted into the T2g orbital. The energy of the T2g orbital, it is lowered by 4dq, and the energy of the Eg orbital, it is raised by 6dq. And the energy gap between the Eg orbital and T2g orbital, it is 10 dq. So the 5d orbitals are splitted here. Now how to distribute the electrons in these T2g and Eg orbitals? There are certain rules belongs to the distribution of the electrons. If the energy required to place the electron in the Eg orbital is greater than the pairing energy, then the electrons will be paired up into the lower T2g orbitals. And if the energy required to place the electron in the Eg orbital is less than the pairing energy, then the electron will be goes into the Eg orbital. So this distribution of the electrons is depends upon the energy gap between the T2g orbital and Eg orbital. If the 10 dq value is greater than pairing energy, then the electrons can be paired up here into the lower T2g orbitals. And if the 10 dq value is less than pairing energy, then the electrons will be entered into the Eg orbital. So related to this distribution of the electrons, now let us going to be discuss about the crystal field stabilization energy. Now, in an octahedral complex with D1 configuration, the single electron will occupy the orbital of lowest energy. We know that according to the above's principle, the electrons will be entered into the lower energy orbital. So for D1 configuration, the single electron will occupy the lowest energy. That electron will be entered into the lower energy orbital. You can see here, this electron for D1 configuration, it is entered into the lower T2g orbital. It means it goes into one of the T2g orbital. There are three T2g orbitals are here. So that electron will be entered into the one of the T2g orbital. Now this T2g orbital is having the energy 4dq less than these degenerate orbitals. It is less than 4dq than the degenerate orbitals. So it means that the energy of the T2g orbital, energy of that electron get lowered by 4dq unit. So this decrease in energy, or gain in energy achieved by the filling of lower lying D levels in a complex is called CFSE. So what is crystal field stabilization energy? The decrease in energy or gain in energy when we distribute the electron in the lower T2g orbital, there will be the decrease in the energy or gain in the energy achieved by the filling of lower lying D levels. Lower lying means lower T2g orbitals in a complex is called crystal field stabilization energy. So what is the meaning of this? When the electrons will be entered into the T2g orbital, the energy of the complex get lowered. There is a decrease in the energy, and the complex gets stabilized more. And generally, the electrons are prefer into the lower energy state instead of going into the higher energy state. Now, how to calculate the CFAC? Now, the formula equation belongs to CFAC is given here. So CFAC, it is equal to number of T2g electrons n T2g multiplied by minus 4dq plus number of electrons in the eg orbital multiplied by plus 6dq. Or this same formula can also be written as CFAC it is equal to number of electrons in the T2g orbital multiplied by minus 0.4 dq plus number of electrons in the eg orbital multiplied by 0.6 dq. So this is also another formula we can use to calculate the CFAC. So particularly this formula can be used to calculate the CFAC in octahedral complexes. So this figure shows arrangement of d1 electron configuration and calculation of the CFAC. So as this electron will be goes into the T2g orbital, the energy of the complex get lowered by the filling of the lower lying d levels in a complex, and that energy it is called as a CFAC. So for this configuration, now let us calculate the CFAC. So it is equal to number of T2g electrons, you can see one electron is there, multiplied by this minus 4dq. Now plus number of eg electrons, number of electrons in the eg orbital, zero, no electrons are here, multiplied by plus 6dq. So it is equal to minus 4dq. So for d1 configuration, in this way the crystal field stabilization energy, it is minus 4dq. It means that the energy of the complex is lowered by 4dq unit, and the complex acquires the higher stability. So in this way, whenever the electrons will be entered into the lower T2g orbital, the complex get stabilized more. Now let us calculate the crystal field stabilization energy for D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7, D8 and D9 configuration. So first, let us calculate the CFAC for D2 configuration. Second, now we already calculated D1 configuration, now D2 configuration. CFAC for D2 configuration. D2 configuration means when there are two electrons in the d orbital. Now the example of this metal ion for D2 configuration, it is titanium dipositive ion. Okay, titanium 2 plus ion. So let us draw here the crystal field splitting energy diagram. The 5d orbitals are splitted into the two groups, that is lower energy orbital T2g orbital and higher energy orbital Eg orbital. So the 5d orbitals now here are divided and splitted into the two groups. Okay, so for D2 configuration, there are two electrons in the d orbital. Now lower T2g orbital and higher Eg orbital, let us represent the energy gap between these two. So this energy gap between the Eg orbital and T2g orbital, it is 10 dq here. Now for D2 configuration, the two electrons will be entered into the lower T2g orbital. So therefore CFAC, it is equal to crystal field stabilization energy equal to number of electrons into the T2g orbital, it is 2 multiplied by minus 4dq plus number of electrons in the Eg orbital, 0, multiplied by plus 6dq. So this is equal to minus 8dq. So for D2 configuration, the CFAC will be minus 8 d cube unit. Or we can use another formula also here to calculate the CFAC. 2 into this factor, it is minus 0.4 d cube, and plus 0 into 0.6 d cube. So in this way also we can calculate the CFAC. It is equal to minus 0.8 d cube here. Okay. So in this way we can calculate the CFAC for D2 configuration. Now for D3 configuration. Let us calculate the CFAC for D3 configuration. So for D3 configuration, there are three electrons. So that third electron is also entered into the lower T2g orbital. Because electrons are preferred to enter into the lower T2g orbitals. Okay. So you can see here, there are three electrons. So 3 multiplied by minus 4 d cube. So this value becomes equal to minus 12 d cube. Calculation for CFAC for D3 configuration. Minus 12 d cube. Okay. Or it is 1.2 d cube. 1.2 d cube minus value. This is 3 multiplied by. So in this way, we calculate the crystal phase stabilization energy for D2, D1, D2 and D3 configuration. Now for D4 configuration, let us calculate the CFAC for D4 configuration. Okay. So for D4 configuration, now you can see here, there are 4 electrons D4. So you can see here, the fourth electron, now it is having the two options. Either the fourth electron can be paired up here, or the fourth electron can be entered into the EG orbital. There are two options for the fourth electron. Two ways we can place that electron. Either that electron can be paired up here, or that electron can be entered into the EG orbital. But it will depend upon the surrounding ligand field. In presence of weak ligand field, as the value of 10 dq is less than pairing energy, it means this energy gap will be less than the pairing energy. So if this energy gap will be less, it means that the fourth electron will be entered into the EG orbital, because 10 dq value is less than pairing energy. So this energy barrier can be crossed by this electron, and electrons are preferred to be entered into the EG orbital. According to the rule, if the energy required to place the electron in the EG orbital is less than the pairing energy, then the electrons will be entered into the EG orbital. Now you can see there are 4 unpaired electrons now here, 3 in T2G and 1 in EG. It means that there are 4 unpaired electrons. So therefore, there are maximum number of the unpaired electrons. 4 unpaired electrons for D4 configuration. So this complex is also called as high spin complex. This complex, it is called as a high spin complex. High spin complex means there should be the maximum number of the unpaired electrons. Okay. So for D4 configuration, there are 2 possibilities. Now that fourth electron can be paired up into the lower T2g orbital in presence of the strong ligand field. Like carbon monoxide, cyano ligands. Okay. So in presence of the strong ligand field, that fourth electron now, it will be paired up into the lower T2g orbital. Okay. So it can be paired up here. So it means that the CFAC for this, in presence of the strong ligand field. Now here 10 dq is greater than pairing energy. Or we can draw here the another diagram. 10 dq is greater than pairing energy. It means this energy gap will be larger. The 5d orbitals are splitted to the greater extent in presence of the strong ligand field. the degree of the crystal splitting will it is greater. This splitting it is greater, and the value of the 10 dq it is also greater. Value of the 10 dq it is greater than pairing energy. So as this energy gap will be larger, the electrons, first three electrons here, we are calculating the CPC here for D4 configuration in presence of the strong ligand field. So first three electrons are goes into the T2g orbital first. Now, as this energy gap will be larger, the fourth electron cannot be goes into the EG orbital. It prefers to paired up into the lower T2g orbital. So what is CPC here? CPC it is equal to number of electrons in the T2g orbital 4 and T2g multiplied by minus 4 dq plus 0 here, number of electrons in the EG orbital plus 6 dq. So this becomes equal to minus 16 dq. So in this way, in the presence of the strong ligand field, CPC value it is minus 16 dq. Now in this case, the ligand field is weak for the same configuration, D4 configuration. D4 configuration. As the energy gap will be less, then the electron, the fourth electron will be entered here into the EG orbital. The fourth electron will be entered into the EG orbital. Because this energy gap will be less. The 5d orbitals are splitted to the lesser extent. So now CPC value will be different here for D4 configuration. So let us calculate the CPC here. Okay. The number of the electrons in the T2g orbital 3. Number of the electrons in the EG orbital now 1. So this value becomes equal to, now this is minus 12 plus 6. So it is minus 6 dq. Minus 6 dq for D4 configuration in presence of weak ligand field. The example of the weak ligand field, it is the ligands like fluoro ligand, hydroxo ligands, even the water molecule, such ligands are called as a weak ligands. And these ligands provides a weak ligand field to the central metal ion. So these orbitals are splitted to the lesser extent. But in presence of the ligands like carbonyl group, carbon monoxide, cyano ligand, ethylene diamine ligand, the crystal P splitting will be larger. The difference between the T2g orbital and EG orbital will be larger. So in that case, the electrons get paired up into the lower T2g orbitals. Once the T2g orbital is filled, then the electron will be goes into the next orbital. So thus, in this way, we calculate here the CPC values for D1, D2, D3 and D4 configuration. So let us write this first. Okay, so we have to write here, first of all, we can make the table here, configuration, first it is D1, okay, then CPC value, crystal phase stabilization energy. So one electron is there that goes to the T2g orbital, so it is minus 4 dq, CPC. Now the electronic configuration for this arrangement, D1 configuration. So in terms of T2g and EG, we can write the electronic configuration here. So electronic configuration. Okay. So when the electron goes into the T2g orbital, so it is T2g 1 and EG 0. EG 0. So, and in presence of the strong ligand field and weak ligand field, it will be same. The CPC will be same because only one electron is there and it will be entered into the lower T2g orbital. Now second, D2 configuration. So for D2 configuration, two electrons are there into the T2g orbital. So we can write here 2 multiplied by minus 4, it is minus 8 dq. EG orbital is not having any electron. So it is electronic configuration, it is T2G 2 and EG 0. Then third configuration, that is D3 configuration. Three electrons are there. You can see once again, I would like to show for a D3 configuration. Whatever the ligand field, it may be weak or it may be strong. But the electrons will be entered into the lower T2g orbital. And there is no electron into the higher Eg orbital here for D3 configuration. D3 configuration. So you can see here there are three electrons in the D3 configuration. So all these electrons are goes into the T2g orbital. No electron into the Eg orbital. And this energy gap, it is 10 dq or delta O. So for D3 configuration, CFSA is equal to 3 multiplied by minus 4 dq. So minus 12 dq this is. And electronic configuration, it is T2G3, EG0, because EG orbital is not having the electron. So this is for D3 configuration. Now fourth one, for D4 configuration. Now for D4 configuration, there are two possibilities. Either that electron can be paired up into the lower T2G orbital, or that electron can be entered into the higher EG orbital. So in presence of the strong ligand field, as there is a larger energy gap between the T2G orbital and EG orbital, there is a larger energy gap between the T2G orbital and EG orbital. So what happens here? For D4 configuration, first three electron will be entered into the T2G orbital. That is correct. But as this energy gap, it is larger, so fourth electron cannot be entered here. It will be paired up here. So in presence of the strong ligand field, the CFSA becomes equal to, CFSA it is equal to, that is 4 multiplied by minus 4. So it is equal to minus 16 dq here. So we can write here minus 16 dq. But now there is a one paired electron. So minus 16 dq plus 1p. This is in presence of the strong ligand field. Similarly, we can calculate the CFSA in weak ligand field also. So in presence of the weak ligand field, you can see here for D4 configuration, the electron will be entered into the EG orbital, as this energy gap will be less. So in presence of the weak ligand field, now the calculation of the CFSA is different. That is 3 multiplied by minus 4 plus 1 multiplied by 6 dq unit. So CFSA is equal to minus 6 dq. So in presence of the weak ligand field, CFSA is equal to minus 6 dq. That is in presence of the weak ligand field, if the ligand field is weak around the central metal ion. So in this way, now there is a difference in the CFSA. In presence of strong ligand field, it is minus 16 dq. You can see the arrangement here. And in presence of the weak ligand field, it is minus 6 dq. So in this way, in this lecture, we have determined the CFSA values from D1, D2, D3 and D4 configuration. We can calculate here the CFSA values from D1 to D4 configuration. Similarly, we can calculate the CFSA values for next configuration, that is from D5 to D10 configuration. So in the next video, I would like to discuss the calculation of the CFSA from D5 to D10 configuration.